You there! Think about how many smart devices most people have nowadays. Smartphones, smart watches, smart robots, smart cars, heck, even smart fridges. So isn't it about time you considered having a smart home? Today, we'll be taking a look at the Samsung Kinect Home, the latest device that combines whole home mesh Wi-Fi and a SmartThings hub all in one. Wow.
With all the advances in home Wi-Fi tech that we've seen in the past few years, using the combo modem and router you got from your internet provider is limiting yourself. Upgrading to a new TP-Link tri-band router is easier than ever thanks to the new TP-Link Tether app. Tri-band routers provide more lanes for Wi-Fi traffic, and TP-Link's Smart Connect feature assigns your devices to the band that works best for them. See how the TP-Link Archer C5400 tri-band router boosted the McNeil's Wi-Fi performance and coverage by clicking the link in the corner or the description.
Astute viewers will notice we have two models in front of us, the Kinect Home and the Kinect Home Pro. The only difference is speed. The regular Kinect Home uses a 2x2 array and has a maximum bandwidth of AC 1300, while the Pro sits at AC 2600 with a 4x4 array. Other than that, both units offer MooMeMo 802.11 AC Wi-Fi and SmartThings compatibility. They both feature one Ethernet jack input and one output, so if you have a lot of hardwired devices, you will need to add a switch. As we mentioned earlier, this is a mesh Wi-Fi system, so adding additional units is a breeze. Each puck is good for approximately 1,500 square feet, and you can place them however you like. You can set any one of them as your main router, and every additional unit after it functions in the exact same way from its SSID to WPA security settings. Along with Wi-Fi, each device also acts as a wireless SmartThings hub. Now, I've said the word SmartThings a few times, and if you don't know what that is, you might be wondering, what is that? To answer that question, let's take a step back and talk about what a smart home actually does. No, it won't make you dinner or fold your clothes. That happens in the Jetsons, and that's a kid's cartoon. But I'm sure you've heard of things like the Nest thermostat and Amazon's Echo. A smart home is simply designed to help assist or automate a lot of otherwise boring and mundane tasks to help make your daily life that much better. The Nest thermostat is one of the best examples. It can help save you money on electricity by only running the heat or air conditioning when there is someone home. You get the perfect comfortable temperature, and it saves energy during the 8+ hours you're away at work or school. Another example is a smart light bulb, such as the Philips Hue. You can have it paired up with a motion sensor so that lights automatically come on when you enter a room and turn off when you leave. As well, you can have them brighter and cooler during the day and dimmer and warmer during the evening. All of this sounds fine and dandy, but it's not quite enough to convert most people just yet. And that's where different ecosystems such as SmartThings come in. Instead of individual gadgets each doing their own thing, you can now share their information with each other to provide an even more cohesive experience. Let's take this scenario for example. It's the middle of winter, it's dark, and it's pouring rain. You're just finished a day of work and you're on your way home. 30 minutes before you arrive, the heater has kicked in and it starts warming up to your favorite indoor temperature of 21 degrees, or 70 degrees Fahrenheit for you Yanks. You park your car, carry a suitcase in one hand and a few bags of groceries in the other for exercise. As you walk near your door, a Kivo smart lock recognizes your smartphone's presence and unlocks the door with a simple tap of your finger. You open it, step inside, and smart LED bulbs gradually come on automatically. Take a few more steps in, and the door automatically locks behind you. Wow. And because we're in Canada, there's obviously a hockey game in progress at that very moment. You ask out loud, "Alexa, what's the score of the latest Canucks game?" 0-3, replies Alexa. Typical Canucks. So instead, you decide to catch up on some TV. Alexa, theater mode. Alexa, continue the last episode of Game of Thrones. As you sit down on your couch, your Sumfy automated blackout blinds start descending. The lights dim, and Netflix starts loading up where you left off on Game of Thrones, except Netflix doesn't have Game of Thrones, Anthony. Oh my gosh. Now, how does that picture I just painted for you with my words sound? Call it smart, call it lazy, or even call it creepy. But the fact is, smart home technology is finally at a point now where all of that and more is possible thanks to ecosystems like SmartThings. By combining multiple sensors and devices together, you can automate entire scripts with a simple voice command, timer, or push of a button. Now, if mundane daily tasks aren't your thing, then don't worry. Another common use for smart home devices is security. Wi-Fi-enabled cameras combined with smoke detectors, motion detectors, and water sensors let you keep a tight grasp on your property even if you're thousands of miles away on vacation. You can easily set up temporary door codes for friends who may be house-sitting, or call the police if you detect an unauthorized intruder. Overall, the strongest feature of the Samsung Connect Home is the sheer compatibility it offers. SmartThings is able to pair up and communicate with Amazon Echo, Google Assistant, Logitech Harmony, Zigbee, Z-Wave, and many Wi-Fi devices such as Nest, Philips Hue, and Belkin's Wemo. And if that still wasn't enough, there's a developer mode to boot. In an uncharacteristic move by Samsung, they actually let you code in custom device handlers. The average dimmable and color temperature adjustable smart bulb, for example, costs anywhere from $40 to $60. With a custom device handler easily found on the SmartThings forum, you can even pair up IKEA's tread-free bulbs that cost just $18 each. Now, coming back to the physical device itself, we found the performance pretty good. We didn't have a 1,500 square foot house to test, but we had pretty good coverage in our office building. Range was reliable on the same floor, but would drop down to just one bar if we went to a different floor. It was, however, still strong enough for us to add another Connect Home and extend the range. Adding additional units is easy enough. Simply find a place still within range and plug in the power. Now, as only a router, the functionality is adequate for 90% of users out there, but it does lack a few features extreme power users may want. It comes with guest network access, device prioritization, and a network restrictor, but that's about it. If you're someone with a fiber optic internet connection, or you stream a lot of local media files wirelessly, or you like to tinker with custom firmware, then you may be better off separately combining a more configurable wireless router and the previous generation Samsung SmartThings hub without a router built in. In the end, we think the Samsung Connect Home is a step in the right direction for an easier smart home experience. It offers a good combination of simplicity, tinkerability with a developer mode, and sheer compatibility that makes it a solid foundation for the future, so you're never locked into one specific protocol. And that's about it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Click over here for previous videos. Check us out on Twitter over here. But as always, like the video if you liked it, comment below for fans with benefits, and subscribe for more videos like this from NCIX. And now, I'm gonna do some smart things with the smart hub after I answer this text. It's Facebook.